Hello and welcome back to yet another video of MCU series. You're watching channel Code X and my name is Afzal. Let's get started and see what we have done so far. In our previous tutorial, we created a custom path like this and we used on-tap gesture of inkwell to navigate to the detail page, and we have a simple detail page like this. Perfect. Let's get started and wrap our widget inside a column. We are going to create a header, subheading and our actual character. So for header, I'll use a text component, that is a text widget, and we'll just duplicate it. So now we have heading and subheading. Let's add some style to our header. So we will give a size of 32, a weight of bold, and yep, that's it. So our heading is looking good. And now let's copy paste the same in our subheading, and we'll remove the bold property and we'll make a size of 24. We'll add some letter spacing so that it looks good, and our heading and subheading is ready. The only thing we have to do is align it to the start. So for that, we'll use a cross axis alignment. And now our header is aligned properly. So for this orange custom card, we want it to take the whole space, whole remaining space. So for that, we'll use an expanded widget. So now this is expanding whatever remaining space it has. It's expanding in that. And now this inkwell, so we are going to work with this card. So what I'll do, I'll just create a new widget. So the best practice is to create a widgets folder or something so that it's manageable. So quickly I'll create one stateless widget and I'll copy paste this thing over there. And this is how you can keep your code manageable wherever you feel like there's a widget that you can move to next some other class, you should. And instead of using this inkwell here, we'll use a newly created card, that is a hero card, and we get the same thing because we have moved the same code over there. Now we need to place our character on top of this orange card. For that, we are going to use a stack widget, and you can easily pull row widget and change it to stack so that you get a children property. And inside this, I'm going to align this box at the bottom. So for that, I'll say alignment and alignment bottom center. Perfect. Now let's add an image and we'll pull this image from assets. So for that, we have to define image.asset and we'll provide asset path of the image. For here, ironman.png. Now we'll have to create asset folder inside our Flutter root directory. For that, right click on your root directory and say new directory. You can name it as asset folder or whatever you want. Let's copy the image and we'll paste this image in our assets folder. Alright. So next thing, still we cannot see the image. Why? Because we have to specify where our assets resides. We can do that by going to our pubspec.yaml file, and here we have to uncomment this assets line. So for the first line, we'll remove the comment, that is not going to change, it will be assets. And for the second line, we'll provide the folder name where we have kept our assets. So this is also same. Okay, now we can see our image. Let's give some alignment to our image and say that this image is already 1.5% zoom. Alright, so that it scales down. And now we'll define a column where we are going to put the title of the character and subtitle. We'll make use of text widget for that. And you can see that these two lines are coming on top. So now we can use a positioned widget that is especially meant for stack, and we can define that we want to position it from bottom 20 pixel and from left, let's say 80 pixel. So now it fits properly. Now let's give some style to it. Again, we have used a cross-axis alignment to align our text from start. Now let's give some padding to our image so that it fits nicely and the UI looks exactly same as dribble. So let's say from top I give padding of 40 pixel. Now this we can do with the help of our media query, so that instead of typing hard-coded value, let's do it with some media query so that we get the dynamic value. So I'll copy this media query from here and let's just paste it over here, and we'll say whatever is the width of the device, give half of that, so we'll multiply by 0.5. so now we'll get a padding which is dynamic and it will change accordingly. Now our hero card is ready. Let's get back to home page and give some overall padding to the column. For that we can wrap it, we can wrap the column inside a padding widget and specify some value like 32 or something, whatever fits for your requirement. This looks nice. Only thing we have to do is align the title and subtitle properly. So let's change the value of left from 80 to 40, and this looks amazing. That's it for this video, guys. I want to keep it short and simple so that you're able to learn and implement at the same time. So we learned about stack, column, image assets, text widgets, styling, and general code practice. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe the channel, do like this video, and put your comment. See you guys in the next one.